I think that this is, I like the law. This is a very beautiful law. As a political science, when I look at the law, I said, this is Israel. This is what we are trying to say, that this is Israel. Let's say to the world, this is what apartheid means. And it is here, in this law. I think that it is true. What you said, Joseph, what was said before, this is not a historical moment. This is not the Balfour Declaration. This is not the Nakba in 48. But this is very important development in the relationship between Palestinians and Israelis. And of course, it tells us a lot about Palestinian politics, Israeli politics, international politics, and of the conflict at all. If we use the term that you use until now for many years, the two-state solution, discrimination, it is over. Yes. Netanyahu helps us very clearly to use the right term. It is apartheid, it is domination, it is the way that this state taking us from one place before 48, before the Nakba, towards some kind of a kind of apartheid. So I think that I will start by saying that it is tells us a huge thing about Israeli politics. It is not by accident that this law happened today or before a few months. Israel, since 2009, I know it was very bad before, it is still very bad. But in 2009, there is a new political system, not legal, not constitutional, nothing constitutional in the new law, nothing. I mean, it is a constitutional, nothing in new constitutional thing. This is, sorry. There is a system of dominance in Israel. This domination comes up in the last four elections by the re-election of Netanyahu and the right-wing, extra-right-wing coalition. If you note, next Israeli coalition will be worse, more right, extreme right, than the previous one, than the one before, than the one before. This means that in politics, in the election meaning, we have right-wing, extreme right-wing dominance. And this happens not because of the conflict, as many will tell us. This happens because of social deep changes in Israeli societies. Society. This means that the coming is, will be worse than the previous ones. And be ready to have much, many more conferences like this. That should invite me next time. And it is not only elections, dominance in election. If you notice, it was clear that the opposition to Netanyahu, the main opposition, this Gantz party, the blue-white party, they have the same political principles like Netanyahu. It is ideological, political, electoral domination in Israel. This is one. The second thing, and this is the essence of my lecture, it's about Palestinian politics. What this law tells us about Palestinian politics. We reach this moment as Palestinians where we have already four types of politics. The first one is the politics of lost. Refugees, politics among refugee Palestinians is over. There is no politics there. And I mean in Jordan, in Syria, in Lebanon and in Iraq. It's almost lost. There, Palestinian PLO were built. There we've been active for 70 years. There we created our main political agendas for the last 70 years. Liberation of Palestine, Palestinian covenant, etc., PLO, etc., etc. It is over. It is sad, But nobody really speaks. I mean, Palestinian Syrian regime rocks destroyed Palestinian, the most important Palestinian refugee in the exile. It's called Yarmouk because of this guy who brought dead into Israel by the regime and, of course, by Russia. The second thing, the second type of politics, I'm telling very in a short terms, is the politics of weight. Palestinians in East Jerusalem, they don't know where they belong. They are waiting. They are neglected by Israelis, but they are neglected by the BA. Palestinian political organizations were closed not only by Israel, by Mahmoud Abbas. And we have to be frank in this regard. You can't have political institution without the building. But they were closed over by Abbas, Mahmoud Abbas, the PA, the BLO. Third, the politics of fragmentation, the failed politics in the West Bank and Gaza Strip. I wrote a book in 2009. It was published by Indiana University Press. It's called The Failed National Movement, Palestinian Politics. I said then, there is no way to make reconciliation between the Palestinians. This is a waste of time to spend time for reconciliation between Hamas and Fatah. What, Hamas people will give Abu Mazen the key to Gaza? He will put them in prison. And vice versa, it's the same. I mean, it is over. There is no way to make reconciliation between the Palestinians. It is very sad, but this is facts. This is politics. I said it in 2009. And there is the politics of faith. It is the politics of Palestinians in Israel. I will say something that sounds very strange to many of you. Palestinian community is in Israel, compared to their demography, their numbers, is the strongest Arab community in the world. We, Palestinians in Israel, compared to our numbers, we are not stronger than Egypt. Compared to our numbers, we are the strongest community, Arab community in the world. And this is the basis, should be the main central core of any change to come. No change can come without Palestinians in Israel. Because are the liaison, the core between the two communities that are fighting over this conflict. Palestinians, the rest of the Palestinians, and Israelis, Jewish Israelis. And you cannot proceed for a peaceful solution without these two components. And we are in the middle. Basically, I think that we have four basic foundations of faith, of power, of strength. This was developed in the last 25 years. I know that story inside. People know me. I write criticism. And I publish waves of skepticism about our situation, because I want to be much more powerful, much more, have more strength as a community. But we are a very strong community.
A few good things, yeah.
Yeah. This is what I'm trying to say. This is unusual, but let's go. We have four or five pillars of the politics of faith among Palestinians and Israel. And you should take us seriously, usually, more than usually we are taken, as Yusuf said. Palestinians in the West Bank, they invite us, struck as, just to give that there are Palestinians from Israel who, in our meetings, in our conferences, they will spend some time to listen to us. One, we have a huge consensus against the Jewishness of the state. Majority, 90% of Palestinians in Israel they are against, and this is the core of any future struggle against the state of the Jewish state of the state of Israel, which is the core of the racist system in Israel. Secondly, we changed demographically. We are almost 1.5 million with a huge community of middle class. In 1960, there was 10 Arab doctors, medicine doctors. Now we have how many? Few, 10 to 20,000. This is a huge change in our community. We have, You know, in the Technion, which is the most important academy in Israel, 25 to 30% of the students are Arabs. In the Technion, I don't know if you know what's the Technion. It's one of the most important technical institutions in the world. So we are trying to organize them very difficultly. As you know, it's very difficult to work among many in closed places. You know, it's politics. Politics in the university usually is more difficult than politics outside the university. So it is normal. Third, we have a strong, vibrant civil society. You hear usually about Musawa, Adala, etc. We have few thousands of NGOs. Many of them, they are not active, but the majority of them are still active. They make work every day in every level. So they are doing very well. We need to improve our quality of work, but we still very, and many, the many knowledge that you have, you hear about in the world about our community, our situation, comes from Adala, from people that active in civil society, and it is very strong civil society. In 2006, we published the Future Vision, which contained the basic principles that agreed between tens of intellectuals that met under the umbrella of the follow-up committee. There was a huge attack against the Future Vision. I don't know if you remember this. It was attacked from all over Jewish communities inside Israel, outside Israel. But we have some kind of a clear vision where we want to go. And this is why it initiates a lot of criticism. Because usually Israelis think about our community, usually in their mind, as very weak, don't have any initiative, and we can control them easily. And then they understand kind of a new generation of Arab activism inside Israel, Palestinian activism inside Israel, which should be counted as part of our power. And the fifth pillar of our power is the new generation of leadership. I am not satisfied with their conduct, and especially the collapse of the joint list, which is a big mistake, historical mistake, and they were punished by the Arab community, Palestinian community, because the collapse of the joint list. But this is a very, it should be said that we, of course, have a new generation of leadership that can take us one further. But in order to take us further, one step further, I think that it is essential to start a new era, as said by Oren Yeftahiel. We cannot continue with the discussion of equality in Israel as the main. I believe in equality. I speak equality. But this is not the main point that which should be emphasized by us. The major point that should be emphasized by all Palestinians and their supporters is the fact we are under the regime of apartheid, segregation, domination, and control. Whatever solution you are seeking, two state, one state, binational, whatever, we Palestinians in Palestine under a system and control. And thanks to Netanyahu, he make it clear that we can use in this conference and people will believe us that there is apartheid system in Israel. I'm active among a group of that called Multaqa Palestine, the meeting of Palestine. Almost 200 Palestinian intellectuals we make regular in Istanbul. We pay tickets from our pockets, don't worry. And we are trying to bring us this idea. It is time to unite Palestinian struggle. We are fragmented. We are weak because we, Palestinians, I mean in general, because we have, Israel succeeded in fragmenting us, not only in the political status. We have different political agendas. We behave as if we are different national groups. And if we believe, really, that we are one national group, we should make a content of this phrase, of this concept. One final word. It is my interpretation. I think the key, of course, this law is a violation of the basic political thing, the modern political thinking, in three basic meanings. It's very important to me to say because I didn't hear these three things. Actually, I hear two, but I nobody speak about the third. It is strange to say, but I know that it is a violation of the concept of self-determination. Self-determination by the Wilson notion, which is contrary to Dr. Joseph, I think that it is a very important tool for our struggle. And we should take it seriously. The concept of nation state is the self-determination of the nation, the American nation, not the white nation. What Israel makes is the violation of the concept of self-determination. It makes it only for the white. This is a violation of the concept of self-determination. This is half of the people who make self-determination in Palestine. And we should make it clear that self-determination have different aspects, but of course you cannot use it in, you can, but you can reach the Nazi experience if you continue with the exclusion of the other. If you really want self-determination, then self-determination should be inclusive, including all the people. Wherever you have more than national group, at least all of them, like in Belgium, here, very, this direction, they both have self-determination, but in a joint and equal foot. And it is a violation of the concept of self-determination from the Jewish aspect. It's because of my own understanding what is a Jewish national group. Because there is no worldwide national group. There is Israeli Jews who have some kind of characteristics of national group. The majority of Jews in the United States, they didn't want to belong to this national group. You cannot say we, the people, the Jewish people, want to declare self-determination in Palestine or in Israel, whatever you want. This is a violation of the self-determination from the Jewish point of view, and of course, from the Arabs in Israel point of view, including Palestinians in Israel, who hold this characteristic of being able to get self-determination as a national minority, at least, if not as part of the general Palestinian people. The second thing is the violation of the collective rights. Of course, there is a huge violation of the collective rights of Palestinians in Israel. And from this, this is the violation of the individual rights of Palestinians in Israel comes not as a reflection of only the political situation or the political policies in Israel. It's a reflection of the violation of the collective rights of the Palestinians in Israel as a collective. And I want to tell you something which I believe in it. All all individual rights are driven, are rooted in collective rights. There is no such, I know that it's very dangerous to say it in London, but I believe in it. There is no such thing separate as said individual rights. The collective rights of being in Britain is derived from the fact that Britain gets self-determination, which is collective rights. The collective rights of the Americans gives rights not only for the in the collective level, it gives it's guarantee the individual right. We cannot reach collect individual rights without reaching collective rights. So, and this starts with a clear fight against the collective domination, which created separation, domination, apartheid system in Palestine. Sure.